Broads Media.
I think it's clear as hell that the league screwed over the Eagles when Washington did everything wrong. They're the one. I can't say everything. That's unfair to say. But knowing Montez Sweat and the way that he's pretty vocal about what he believes in and things of that nature, him testing positive, then there is this spread. See, the Eagles had an issue with Dallas Goedert earlier in the season. That didn't translate to the whole team going under this COVID protocol. Now you see Quez Watkins have that issue. You don't see the entire team going through all this COVID protocol stuff. So there's a correlation between what's happening with Washington and the way they are handling business compared to the Eagles going through the proper steps. And when you analyze that, now the Eagles somehow get boned because of that Sunday game the following week against the Giants. There's really no debating. There's really no fight or you know, debate on what's happening here. The Eagles got screwed. So there were three options here if you're the National Football League on what you could have done to handle this. And what they ended up doing was a knee-jerk reaction. And just to be fair, what I tell Sixers fans all the time not to do is make a knee-jerk reaction on Ben Simmons to try and save this season, because most of the time that ends up being the wrong answer. Aha! Look what we have right in front of us. The league did something stupid and quick because they felt pressure and they needed to do something, and it ended up being the wrong answer. Just remember that. So they had three options. One, forfeit. Two, make Washington play with 20-plus players in COVID protocol, which now we know wouldn't have even been the case, and they probably would have had players back for that Sunday game, so they screwed up. And then three would be move the game. So one was never on the table. No matter what they said earlier in the season, before things got going, it was a threat. It was a threat to make players feel the need to get vaccinated, so if anything was to happen and players forfeit and whatnot, and they don't end up getting paid, you know, it's like, I don't want to be that guy. You want all those teammates and players around the league, which is a small inner circle, to be disgusted with you and pissed off with you? No, you don't. So it's a big threat, and it was never actually going to happen. These players want to get paid, both sides. So, and let's be real here. Yes, we're mad the game got moved to Tuesday, but it's less about playing on Tuesday, more about the following game against the Giants and the time for recovery. And I can't believe it. There's beat reporters in New York just destroying, and I mean destroying the Eagles fans right now for the outrage, saying, oh, you weren't pissed off last year when you basically threw the last game of the season to screw the Giants so you can get a better draft pick. And I can't believe that the league making this decision and the Eagles losing a game. So a 6-10 team, let's be clear here, a 6-10 team didn't get into the playoffs. Play better, right? You can control that. That's a controllable from the New York Giants. Be better. Don't fuck up. Don't suck. Don't blow. Don't be a bad garbage football team. And then you don't have to rely on the Eagles. With this, the league just took it and made this the issue. So this is two totally different circumstances. I don't even see how it's even relatively close to the same exact conversation. This is out of control for the Sixers, for the Eagles. Excuse me, I'm sorry. With all this noise circulating here between both parties, you know, my brain's in a pretzel and I'm all twisted. I got so much going on here. I'm supposed to be on the Fanatic tonight. Am I leading you into Sixers basketball? Am I not? Am I going extra time? Am I not? The phone's blown up. We're trying to figure out everything. The schedule is all a mess at the moment. So as you could imagine, you know, I'm all in a loop here. And yeah, I might have just chugged a 24-ounce of extra caffeinated Wawa coffee, so I'm buzzing and I can feel it jolting through my body. But when is that not the case, if we're being honest? Now, getting back on track here, with the forfeiting, never going to happen. Never, ever, ever going to happen. So, option number two, force Washington to play. That's ding, ding, ding. That's it right there. That's the move. Now, when I was getting the news that Heinicke was on the COVID list, I'm not going to lie to you. I was sitting in Starbucks, ironically enough, here's a coffee story, sitting in Starbucks waiting to get my chestnut praline latte venti, hot, whipped cream on top, and I'm sitting there like, damn, this is taking forever. I hate this damn drive-thru, but I'm part of the problem also because I'm obsessed with what they do, therefore so is everybody else, and we're all sitting there thinking the same damn thing. And I go, my instant reaction, no way. There's no way they play this football game.